Now, Celtics fans will tell you he is the best player on the court, scoring 23 points in each of the Celtics' first two playoff games. Now, he referred to Eric Bledsoe as Drew Bledsoe after game one, which maybe
mistake.
Would explain this
mistake.
After game two last night.
Terry Rozier's gotten off to a strong start to the series, no turnovers in 78 minutes. How personally do you take that matchup?
Who?
Terry Rozier.
I don't even know who the that is.
I like Eric
a lot. You don't know who that is?
I really do. I like Eric a tremendous amount. I am confused sometimes about some of the things he says.
He know who he is. I wish this was
that is the most
another channel that we can really voice our opinion on.
Now listen, I can understand saying that before the series.
You can say whatever you want.
Hard in this situation,
Rachel. Before the series, you can say that, but after you getting your butt busted, that's unprofessional for not knowing the scouting report and not knowing who your assignment is.
But
he knows,
but he needs to wake up and figure it out.
For that man to be a backup player, this is a role player that's giving you buckets, right? Giving you buckets on this play right here, the go-ahead three, and you about to run to the paint. Couldn't come out and contest the shot.
Hey, if you don't
better know who he is.
You don't know who that is. You're going to know where y'all
he's the guy.
The playoffs. And you're watching
the playoffs.
The
guy that's outscoring you and your backcourt mate 25-96.
That's pretty embarrassing.
That's very embarrassing.
You should know who that is.
Man, what?
He knows who it is. It's just...
You can't say that, Rachel.
You don't talk... He's talking trash.
That ain't talking trash when that man is...
talking trash when you're getting...
You're playing that type of defense. You don't respect him, and you don't know who he is.
Nah, I mean, that's not the right thing.
He's just trying to say I don't respect him, and to me, I feel as if you need to show that on the court before you show that...
I like the fact that he's doing it even though he's getting his tail bust.
I don't understand.
You know?
Typically,
guys talk trash when they also are playing well. He's not playing well, and he's still trying to trash talk. So I got to give him some props on that. But come on, bro. You got to step your game up, dog.
I don't understand what Eric Bledsoe has done in this league to talk like this. Like, you're still trying to establish yourself.
You say,
by the way, producer Danny is in my ear being like, you move on to the Bucks. You can see the bottom of the crawl. It's like, what's the Bucks' biggest problem? And Paul Pierce cannot get past this incident.
What you mean with the biggest problem? That's the biggest problem right there. The backcourt for Milwaukee Bucks. You are getting outscored 96-25. They don't have Kyrie Irving. They have a young player in Brown and Terry Rozier, and they are kicking their butts.
What about the system that the Bucks are playing, if you could even identify one? But it was supposed to change after Jason Kidd got fired.
What kind of system can you run? You have an all-world player and a guy who can get to the bucket. He's great in transition. You need to put shooting around him. Look at Ben Simmons. He doesn't take threes. This guy is a great player, and I'm talking about Giannis Antetokounmpo. Mm-hmm. He needs shooters around him, guys that can make shots. Look at these guys throwing up bricks.
Middleton and Giannis are doing their job. Yeah, they're not getting any help from
Bledsoe
nobody else.
Bledsoe has to make shots. Snell has to make shots. Jabari Parker, they have to make 3 points.
That's why I had Celtics winning this series, because I knew these guys. I know, like I said, I know what the Celtics are all about. I know their identity. These guys are going to compete. They have young, hungry talent on this team, and they're well coached. We don't know who Milwaukee Bucks are. Now we're starting to see that.
Okay, that's what I'm trying to get to, and I'm trying to talk around it to be nice, because I think it is tough to be put in the position Joe Prunty was put in, where you get the team halfway through the season. It doesn't sound like you're getting the full-time job. It's sort of this weird other world.
It's hard for the coach.
But it doesn't feel like they are getting coached the same way as the team on the other side of the floor.
It's hard to put that on the coach, because he took over midseason.
Well, that's what I mean.
He didn't have time to put his stamp on his team.
But I'm not seeing what I'm seeing from Brad Stevens and his staff.
I mean, Brad Stevens has established himself as a great coach. He's won 54 games without
his
key free agent signing this summer.
Bledsoe can't be talking like
that.
And
you're missing.
Back to that.
You can't do it. You just can't do it.
There we go. Back to that.